Thank you so much, Colleen. That was wonderful to hear you, Peg. Where are you? Where did she go? That was gorgeous. Thank you. Thank you to Weather Awards, and thank you to all the friends and fellow word lovers who are here tonight. I'm reading from this book that just came out called The Lost Sketchbook of Edgar Degas, with a wonderful press in San Francisco, Outpost 19. I'm just going to read two short passages. The book.
Oh, is,
excuse me,
oh,
we can't hear you back.
Oh, is this oh, this is. May I continue to open my eyes, and may her light is shining inside me. So this second and last passage I'm reading is from the opening of chapter 3. This book actually, as I said, takes place all in the course of one day. So by now we're about late morning. Here, this is in the voice of Estelle, Estelle Musson Bafour de Gaulle, or otherwise known as Tel. And again, it's 10 years after de Gaulle. She's holding the sketchbook in her lap. She can't see it. You'll hear me mention Odile is her 10-year-old daughter who's still alive. Mouche was her sister, beloved sister, who had died in childbirth a few years before this. Josephine was her daughter, who apparently was the one who squirreled away the sketchbook in my fiction, and who died at the age of 18. Who at this point in the text has died. So, Estelle's voice. Edgar said Odile was a very good model for a one-year-old. One day, though, like an absent-minded uncle, he gave her a handful of marrons glacés, which she ate immediately, one after the other, until she got sick. He gave Carrie some too. And Mouche, that Carrie's white dress had to come off afterward and go to the wood to be washed because it had gotten so sticky from the glaze. Here on my lap is something Edgar held once and many times, something he opened often to record what he saw in a pretty, messy, crowded house. I wonder if Edgar still misses this sketchbook. I wonder what his days are like now. He must have built dozens. Hundreds more such books since that winter when he was our guest. Had Josie squirreled this one away even before the day he left? Or did she come upon it after he'd set sail for Havana? She liked him, that much was certain. Maman, she said one evening at bedtime, Cousin Edgar is going to put me in the picture too. I will be the only one standing, he says, right at the open door. To think that she held onto his sketchbook of Edgar's all those years. My pack rat, I used to call her. My magpie. She saved everything. Place cards, bird's nests, a harmonica still in its case. The toy trumpet Edgar gave her when she was a baby in France. Cross-stitch projects started and abandoned. Seashells with sand still inside. Her father's embroidered handkerchief. As she started to grow up, she saved satin boxes filled with all kinds of things, her necklaces, invitations to balls, pressed flowers, charm bracelets. Then there were her sketchbooks, too, of all sizes and shapes. She became quite proficient, my sisters said, at drawing, and by the time she was 17, she'd started pen and watercolor. What devotion helped her keep Edgar's sketchbook secret? Or did she simply forget about it? Did it become just one more object she had wanted to keep safe among all her other things, and yet had forgotten? I wish I could hold on to it in any case. Poor Papa has tried for years to get even one canvas for Edgar, especially the one he did of Mouche on the balcony, which Papa admired. And Edgar has ignored his requests. Why? I have no idea. It's as if he has forgotten us all, and yet, that winter, I thought he loved us.